happens in a dictatorship mode. So that's what what you could do for your organization, basically.
Hello, Luke. My question about exercise. I'm here.
Yeah, okay.
Is it okay to exercise twice a week or thrice a week or daily we have to do it? What is the composition and combination like? You have to do one day yoga, one day walk, jog, gymming, too much confusion.
It's perfect. The more you mix it up, the better it is for your body. So you could have a day of walk, a day of yoga, a day of doing nothing. It's absolutely fine so long as your body is going through some movement. But if you're doing weight training every day, your body gets more and more rigid. You do yoga every day, you just get more and more flexible. So it's always good to do something for endurance, something for flexibility, something for strength. So keep mixing and matching. And you could do yoga in the evening and weights in the morning. It doesn't matter. In fact, that's a great combination. But it's up to the time that you have. So keep mixing it up. The body gets used to things very quickly. It reaches a plateau. So we got to keep mixing stuff up, basically.
Hi, could you throw some light on this prebiotics and probiotics, like so many strands, you know, so many billion strands and so many products in the market? Very confusing.
Okay, so why do you look at a product? Why don't you look at natural food for a prebiotic and a
probiotic? No, but we're not aware of. I've only heard about yogurt as being a probiotic.
Yeah, that's a probiotic. So for a probiotic to be sustainable in the body, it needs a prebiotic to feed it. So for example, I would use maybe an apple cider as a prebiotic and a yogurt as a probiotic. Or in India, we have the isabul, the psyllium husk. That's a great prebiotic. So you have it like 30 minutes before a meal, it becomes a prebiotic. And then you have your pickled vegetables or you have your yogurt after a meal, that becomes a probiotic. But a probiotic without a prebiotic is useless. So when people sell you probiotics and there's no prebiotic, it doesn't complete the whole thing. The probiotic needs the prebiotic, basically.
Hi, look, I have just one quick question.
Yeah.
Thanks for the wonderful recap on all the principles of living healthy life. I had a question, you know, because I'm a yoga freak. I like doing yoga. But they say that yoga has to be done on empty stomach. But by the time you eat and finish like those 2 or 3 hours of gap, again, you start feeling hungry. So can you just throw light on that?
So you should eat. If you're feeling hungry, you should eat.
Yeah. But then you cannot do yoga for at least 1 or 2 hours. So How can you just, because every 2 to 3 hours, you start feeling hungry. By the time you start feeling like you want to do yoga, you again start feeling hungry. So what should be eaten before yoga? What food can be eaten before having yoga?
The best combination before yoga is fruit and nuts, basically.
And you can do immediately yoga in half an hour's time?
At least half an hour. At least half an hour.
Thanks. So that answers my question.
Okay.
Luke, excellent presentation. Can you suggest a lifestyle changes for autoimmune disease such as arthritis?
Mm-hmm. So it's very difficult to throw light on that in this time, but the number one is most people who have arthritis have an autoimmune disorder. They have a leaky gut or they have a poor gut and they have very acidic bodies. So the fact is, because they're acidic, their bones start leaching calcium, magnesium and D3. And that's why the bones get more and more weaker and they pain. So the root cause is acidity. You got to take care of acidity. When you take care of acidity, the gut starts healing. When the gut starts healing, arthritis as an autoimmune disorder starts falling in place. So that's why it's got to be an integrated method to, you know, treat it basically. So it's mainly acid and alkaline again.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi. You said that 70% of our food should comprise of, we should have raw food or juices. And at the same time, you also said we should stick to our basic, you know, habits when we were small, what we were fed on. Generally, I've seen like we have a lot of knowledge of food and everything, you know, nowadays. But whenever we try to change something, make drastic changes, we get more problems, into more problems like, you know, and all that. So when we were young, we were not fed like 70% salads and all. Now, whenever we try to change, take seeds or something, we get more problems than actually curing ourselves. You know, we don't know the root causes and we end up going to doctors for some allergies and we mess up our system. So how can one overcome that problem? You know, we know this is nutritious food, but it doesn't gel with our system. So that means we should go back to our old system, like have more cooked food, which is not nutritious, or should we stick to the raw food, which doesn't suit us?
No, why is it not suiting you? You need to ask yourself that question first. Yeah. Is your digestive system
But we don't know the root cause, and when we have some other problem by eating nutritious food, we end up going to doctors, and as you said, doctors don't treat the root cause, right? So how does one know about it? And
I can't
you
answer
said
your
lifestyle change, everybody yeah. knows the lifestyle, but it doesn't suit you.
Yeah, but I don't know your problem, so I can't suggest the lifestyle change for you. I don't know your problem, so how do I help you with
Suppose
the lifestyle
Suppose if you
change?
Eat a seed and you get allergy, you said the root cause is something else, but
say that again?
Eat seeds or something.
Yeah.
Many people I've seen having allergy with seeds.
Okay.
So the doctor says anything which gives you allergy, you have to stop eating completely. But where do you get nutritious then?
Okay, so if you stop eating seeds, you can still continue eating fruits and vegetables, right? So it's a balance of energy. So if you have to stop a particular food group, then you keep, you know, substituting it with something else. It doesn't mean you make a whole change.
Okay.
But the reason is, why do you have an allergy in the first place? So you've got to check the health of your liver. So
okay.
we can't just remove the seed, but we check the health of our liver, and accordingly we make that change. So you got to get to the root cause even for that, basically.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Last question, please.
Yeah.
Hello, Dr. Luke. This is Sammy here.
Yeah.
Hi.
Okay. My question is that I travel a lot. So whenever I travel to Canada or US, we get a jet lag. Okay.
Right.
So what we do is we take a sleeping pill and we sleep and we try to make our routine life back, but it does not happen. We
right.
feel very drowsy. We feel very tired. So this is a right practice. And one more question, that is there is a way to come out from this jet lag where we can do some sort of exercise or something which will be, we come to the normal life? Because whenever we travel, 4-5 days goes with that only.
Correct.
So then again, we have to come back for the, back to the country, again the same thing happens. So
yeah.
what is your suggestion? Like, what can you advise on this something?
Jet lag, I've not figured out for myself either. So, but don't do a sleeping pill, because sleeping pills are addictive. At the most, do melatonin if you have to. You know, melatonin is more natural and more easier for you to manage, basically. But trying to align your flight timings with, you know, your native place time and your time zones is one of the best pieces of advice, but it's never worked for me. So I'm the last person to ask advice on jet lag. I've never figured it out for myself. But don't do sleeping pills. Do melatonin instead. That's going to be easier on your system, basically, and less addictive. So that's how it is. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Dr. Lee. On that note, with a brilliant and insightful presentation, don't you all agree that a lot of our myths are busted and shattered today regarding meditation, exercise, diet, food, everything, isn't it? Wonderful. Give him a big round of applause, please. Wonderful. I mean, we have all like learned so much from you. Thank you, Luke. And now I'd like to call upon stage our president, Ms. Bindu Chetur, and also Mr. Nimish Makwana to hand over a memento to you. I will also request Mr. Rahul Srivastava to come on. Now I'd like to request Mr. James Matthew, our administrative board member, to come onto the stage and also present a memento to Mr. Sahul Agarwal. He is the chairman of the Sahul Group, who has been instrumental in having this great talk show out here. Thank you. Now, can I please request all the board members to quickly come onto the stage for a group photo, please?